This God is only one, and it cannot be more than one. Right here, Christianity goes right to the waste. There cannot be any divine entity, only one. No two and not more than two. Right? Why? Because if you would have two gods, each one of them would be limited and subject to the other god's decision. If both of them are omnipotent, that's the right word. If both of them call Yachol, they have no limitation and can do anything, can create anything, imagine they fight now. They begin to go in a fight or a chess game. It will never end. It's because there's two perfect things. It will take forever. One wants this, one wants the other one. You know what would happen in the world? There will be a chaos. Once there is another perfect God, the first one is already not perfect. Then the second one is not perfect because there's someone else that can affect him. So anyone that is subject to any other entity's effect is already not perfect. And the Torah says clearly that that's the perfect God, and he knows the future, and he runs everything, and he controls everything. If there was another God, then we cannot rely on the one God that gave us the Torah. Maybe the other God doesn't like the Torah. Maybe the other God promotes same-sex marriage. Now they're going to go into a nuclear war. I want men and men to get married, and I hate it. It's abomination. Who's to say the last word? Boom, the whole world will go on fire. It's ridiculous. Don't get me wrong. We don't need all this philosophy. It's already written in verses in the book of God, and he's not a liar. But now we're analyzing it with our own philosophy and logic. Even if we didn't know that it's written in the Torah, we will still have to come to this conclusion on our own. So this God is one and not two and not more. Ela echad she'en ki yichudo. There's one that there's no one like him. Not from the people or anything that exists in this world, and not from anything out of the world. He's not one that is connected by few that connected to one piece, like a car. You have engine, you have transmission, you have a carburetor, you have sensors, you have wheels. You connect everything, it becomes a perfect machine. You take one wheel out, the machine is worthless. You take one wire out, you can start the car, it's not worth a penny. If you take one sensor out, and there's nowhere in the world to get this sensor. This Bentley from 300,000 went down to 3 cents. Maybe you can use it as a tent. Maybe you're gonna build a sukkah there, cut the roof and put some branches. Why? You can use it. Wow, it's such a nice car, but you cannot start it. And what good is that? So it means in order for the car to be perfect, it needs lots of pieces to be connected in the right places and in the right timing, and to work together in a perfect harmony. That God is not like that. He's one. And there's no connections to him, or upgrades, or pieces who got together to create that perfect supervisor. So, if there were many gods, then we would not have any control in any events. Nothing would be certain. There would no point of giving Torah when there is another superpower who can overrule everything that it's written over there. God say, if you be Mechalel Shabbat, you lose your eternity and you put to death. The other God would say, no, I disagree with this ruling. I want it to be like this. What are you going to do now? Follow the Torah or get the other God angry? It's not possible.